ఫైనలీ చైతన్య మహాప్రభు ఈజ్ కృష్ణ హింసెల్ఫ్. యు సీ ద డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ కృష్ణ అండ్ చైతన్య మహాప్రభు, బోత్ ఆర్ ద సేమ్. ద పర్పస్ ఆఫ్ ఈచ్ వన్ ఈస్ డిఫరెంట్. ద పర్పస్, ఈవెన్ మీ యూ కెన్ టేక్ ద ఎగ్జాంపుల్ హియర్. I am doing like this one. At my home, I don't do like this one, is it? I am different at my home. You know, I am different. And if I go to temple, I am different. Same person, according to the purpose, I behave differently. The relationship also different. My home, I have my different relationship. Here, I have different relationships. If I go to temple, my relationship is different. So according to that one, my abhideya is different. That's why I got the prayojana, benefit. Isn't it? So same Krishna, he taught Bhagavad Gita 5,000 years ago. Then immediately after, he had to leave this planet. Then that is the end of Dwapara Yuga, actually. Then it comes to Kali Yuga. In Kali Yuga, no one comes, descends from upper planetary systems. Even the demigods, they never come to this earthly planet. Earlier, they used to come. All the demigods, they used to come. Even Narada, Hanuman. But now we cannot find all of them. They don't come to this middle planetary system. So even in impossible condition, Krishna has come. How? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu form. He has not come as Krishna himself. The beauty, you see, Krishna can make impossible possible. Same Krishna has come, but his purpose is different. Speaking Bhagavad Gita, the purpose is different, giving the knowledge. But he cannot come Kali Yuga. But still he is coming. And then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission was over. He left this planetary system. Again they are there. How they are there? Name. There is no difference between his name and the form. How great Krishna is. How nice Krishna as a father. If you understand him, if you glorify him, we will become confidential servant of Krishna. This is very, very important. Becoming confidential servant of Krishna. Nowadays, even the wives are not confidential to their husbands. Husbands are not confidential to their wives. Isn't it? They have their own secrets. So that's why these divorces and all is there. Otherwise, there was nothing like that. In Vedic culture, there is no divorce. Even when I was a child, nothing, no divorce. My aunts, both aunts, their husbands are drunkards. They drink and come and beat. They both left their bodies. But there was no divorce at all at that time. Nowadays, because of the education, misleading, illusory knowledge of the ladies, they are ready to give divorce. So this and all spoiled by ourselves, our government, our parents. Isn't it? That's the problem. At least in our ISKCON society, we should re-establish the Vedic culture. That's the purpose. Father told me, what is the statement? We have to do Sankirtana movement. We have to accept the Sankirtana movement. What is the Sankirtana movement? Kirtana means? Kirtana means?
Individual.
What individual? Kirtana means glorification. We have to glorify Krishna because he is such a father. Even in Srimad Bhagavatam, we are parallelly going through. Huh? Yesterday I was talking about the energies of Krishna. Next week I am going to talk about the wonderful activities of Krishna. Huh? Next class in Bhagavatam. Huh? So nice. If you understand Krishna, you don't think of anything else. Huh? The beauty, the taste is there. Isn't it? So, what I was talking?
The statement.
Statement, like, Sankirtana. Kirtana means glorifying the Supreme Father. My father is good, my father is good, that's okay. But all coming together, we are telling, our father is good, our father is good, our father is good. How nice it is? What we can find in that one? What we can find in the, my father, our father. What's the difference there?
Cooperation.
The cooperation. Each son is cooperative to other son. The Supreme Father is not happy. My father is good, my father is Krishna is happy to some extent. But all coming together, our father is good, our father is good. How much he is happy? Isn't it? Sankirtana means all coming together as though they have difference of opinion, keeping away, keeping the difference of opinion away and coming together and sharing the same thing to glorify Krishna. Unity in diversity. That brings happiness to Krishna. Isn't it?